So, I am so sorry for not being here on Friday or Saturday as regularly planned. A bunch of stuff came up. So, anyway, we're here, we're back. I'm gonna do a bit of a longer live tonight to make it up to you guys. So, we're looking at least 2.5 hours tonight. We'll see how it goes. Good to see you, Strawberry. And I did pull out a bunch of different props that I wanted to work with tonight. So we'll see where the night. Just gonna start with some like stippling on your face. I sensed it, Layla. I'm back, Sophie. I missed you all too. So, I think we're gonna dive right in. I have so much out, I don't know where to start. I think I'm gonna start with the kitten and the yarn ball. So, since I don't have anything for spider webs, this has been my workaround. So, just imagine you are the sweetest little kitten who's just gotten stuck here in this ball of yarn, and I'm gonna do my best to get you out. So we're just gonna be pulling on different strings here, just think if we can get you all untangled. How did you get so tangled, my love? Hello. And let me see if I could just pull this one, even if I could just get one paw. Angles like this, it gets a lot worse before it gets better. So I'm just gonna keep tugging. Alright, and I think we can get your left front paw through here. Right through here. Thank you. And then if I take this over, make sure to get your tail. Imagine you'll be a bit more careful playing in the stream in the future. I really have gotten this really tangled. This is all I've been using this for recently. Alright. I think the next thing I wanted to do, I want to go ahead and measurements, if that's all right. So let's see, and I want to record them too so I can remember for next time. Let's just find an empty page here. Okay, and make sure my pen's working. Perfect. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and take some measurements of your face. So starting here, I'm going to go ahead and start from the top of your ear to the top of your ear on the other side. So we're just going to take that measurement there. Alright, make sure we've got this somewhat level. No one's face is perfectly symmetrical. Alright, we're looking at... Go ahead and go from the hairline all the way down to the bottom of the chin here. All the way down the center of the face. I'm kind of lining it up with your nose. Okay, good. Alright, so now that we've center part here, we'll start taking some additional measurements. So I'm going to go ahead and measure your eyebrows next. So I'm going to be taking the space in between the space from start to finish, and we'll also take the width of each eyebrow. Need a lot of details on the eyebrows. So starting with the distance in between. Yeah, so let me just knot that down. Now we're going to go again from the outside to the outside. Okay, so there. All the way over. Okay, that's things. Alright. And now we're just going to take the width at the front. Slight difference between the two. Again, that's no surprise. So your right one is about a centimeter smaller than your left one. Alright, now we're going to go ahead and measure the bridge of the nose. So right between the eyes, down to the base on the top of the lip, and then we'll go from one side of the nostril to the other, and then we'll go ahead and go out. Alright, so we'll start from right between the eyes, down, down, just to the bottom here. Good. Okay, and then from one side to the other, just spanning that distance. Go ahead and have you turn your head to the side. Perfect. I'm just going to take this measurement. Your nose is so cute. You know, I think I'll have to, Layla, just to fix that slight difference in your eyebrows. Okay. And then we're going to go ahead and do the jaw. So we're going to go ahead and kind of press up and get that flat measurement like that to the center. So I'm going to need, we're going to go ahead and use this as a flat back. So I'm going to tuck this right against the side. Side as well. lastly, we're just going to go ahead and measure your lips. So be looking at the width of the mouth and the thickness of your top and bottom lip. So from the corner to the other. And just look at that distance. Okay. Right, and then the thickness. You're one of those special individuals who has pretty equal length on your top lip and bottom. Alright, perfect. So we've taken the necessary measurements. And if it's alright, I'm just gonna quickly help you clean up your brows just a little bit. And we're gonna have to use a big one because I don't know where my little ones are. I'm gonna go ahead and move in a little closer, if that's all right. All right, just go ahead and hold still for me. Doing a lot better. I'm sorry for bailing on you, all of you, over the weekend. Just had a lot going on this weekend. I know, speaking of, I think some of my new nail product I might be allergic to because I started getting like this blood blister looking thing. I'm not entirely sure, but that's why I don't have any nails because I started having a weird reaction. So I think we're gonna take a break from press-ons and acrylics for a while and just let my nails have a break, so it's gonna be different tapping for a while. Look. Hi, Chloe. Alright, so we've gotten most of the plucking taken care of. I just want you to all know that I just saw my shadow across the bed, and I was like, what the hell is that? Just scared myself with my own shadow. And then we're just gonna go ahead and trim just above. Yeah, me too. They don't hurt, which is good. Like, even though they look a little red and puffy, I'm not experiencing any pain, so I'm gonna count that as A-okay. I conferred with Dr. Google today, and it looks like, you know, there's a couple, like, infections you can get around your fingers, and it seems like most of it will go away at home, so I'm trusting. I was really bad at remembering some channel names, but there's a gentleman who does like fast cranial nerve exams, and he likes to run his pencil up and down a ruler towards your face. Something about it is so relaxing. If any of you know who I'm talking about, full credit to that creator. But I love this like I know, so true. You have to be careful. I try and be like really specific, because if you just type in like finger swelling, you'll get like liver failure and stuff like that, I'm sure. So I try and be like a little bit of redness around the nail bed, and that tends to help. Alright. Okay. Now we had a request for car ride. So we'll go ahead and do a little bit of car ride. I think I might try this black light tonight. I don't know, we'll see. Go ahead and turn off the ring light here, so it's gonna get dark in 3, 2, 1. I am wholly unprepared for it to be Christmas already. Let's see. Got that light. It's really snug up on me. Let's see that light. This light. I feel like this looks more car-like. It's kind of a diffused light. Alright. I want you to close your eyes if you're comfortable doing so, and imagine that you're riding in the front seat of a car. Someone you love and trust very much is driving the vehicle. The temperature in the car is perfect, and the gentle distantly note the passing of headlights over your closed lids. And in this moment, you feel safe, comfortable, and relaxed. Your friend and you decided to go for a little on some quiet back roads. So you're just cruising, looking at all the holiday lights. Thank you for the cocoa treats. And you're dreaming of the hot cocoa you'll get. Enjoy it in front of the fireplace. But you've been out looking for Christmas lights for a bit now, so your sleepy little eyes have fallen closed. And behind your lid, beautiful flashes of color, golds and greens, reds and blues. It's very much a Christmas rave happening in your dreams right now. And then you feel the car come to a gentle stop, and your friend ever so gently nudges you awake with the promises of hot cocoa, and then the lights come on in 3, 2, 1. Gets bright really quick, doesn't it? Alright, thank you for that, Coco Teresa. Now I think I've got a couple role plays planned, and I think we're gonna go ahead and move into our lengthy one, which is gonna be doctor checkup, all the things. So let me get my gloves on, which are much easier to don without acrylics, let me tell you. Look how clean that was. As much as I love nails, things like gloves on. Yes. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do some tingle train, and X marks the spot right after the doctor role play. Okay, I think I'm gonna zoom out just a little bit. Alright, so you've come in today for a standard checkup, and we're going to be testing some of the basic things that you'll test at the doctor, taking some basic health information. You know the things. I have a degree. Really, I do. So let's go ahead and start with a temperature reading. So I'm going to just press this near your forehead. Alright. So it's telling me it's dangerously low. So, were you out in the cold for very long? Okay. Well, we'll see. The next thing I'm gonna go ahead and do is just check on your heart. Heartburn. Well, can't be that bad a heartburn because your temperature's so low. Alright. Some sizzling sounds. Surprising. Okay. Now I want you to go ahead and take a deep breath in for me. And out. Breathe in again. And out. Habanero peppers will definitely create a little volcano, so. I bend. And now. Okay. Well, besides your slightly low temperature and the crackling I'm hearing, your lungs sounded fine. Those sound like they're working perfect. Let's go ahead and just kind of check your eyes. So first off, I'm going to just get a nice close look at them. So just go ahead and just hold them open as best you can. Just take a look. A little dirty. You've been sleeping very well. No, okay. Anything in particular? Stress? Gaming? Anything that's keeping you up late? I thought as much. Alright, I want you to go ahead and look here at my nose. Yeah, new jobs can be really stressful. And we're gonna see if we can find a few ways to help you manage your stress. Because sleep is very important to the body, so if you're continually losing sleep, we're gonna start to see some physiological effects crop up. Right. Good. Now I want you to go ahead and tell me when my fingers have left your field of vision. So continue focusing right here on the tip of my nose. Now, sounds like that stress. Good. is causing your body to stay wired. Now, I'm going to ask a couple of follow-up questions, and these are ones that I've just seen a lot of. Now, do you unplug from technology at a certain time, or are you looking at your phone right up until you try to go to sleep? I feel that, Sophia. Good. Alright, and now tell me how many fingers you see out of the corner of your eye. Continue to look here at my nose. Good. Okay. So, one thing that can help is definitely to put away the technology at least 20 to 30 minutes before bed. Not only does the light from your device affect your circadian rhythm, but also the constant stimulus can keep your brain from shutting down. Obviously, ASMR with the phone turned off is an exception. Now we'll just test your color vision a bit. So I appreciate that so much, Strawberry, because my retirement through work, it has a little calculator, and I have it set for 35. I'm almost 33. I have it set for 35, and I refuse to move it. I'm not going to retire by 35. There's no way. Keep it there just on the off chance. But let me tell you, my projected monthly payout off of my retirement is like $124 or something like that if I retire at 35. I refuse to move it. TV as well. You can turn the lights down if you like to have sound in the background. There are also noise machines if you like background sound, ones that don't really emit too much light. Softer lights like night lights are acceptable, just nothing too bright. Another thing that can help you are nightly routines, yoga, meditation, breath work, things like that that you do in a routine that start to trigger your body to understand that we're going into like a sleep state. So even though setting routines can be very difficult, you will find that if you start doing nightly routines, like a nightly meditation, your body is going to start to kind of recognize, so kind of like Pavlov's bell. Your brain will start to associate that with sleepy time. Now, let me just check your good. Now I want you to close your eyes for me. Close your eyes and tell me which side of your head you're hearing the snap on. Good. Okay. Good. Excellent. Now I'm going to go ahead and whisper a number to you, and I want you to repeat it back. Now, a word. Strawberry. Good. And one more. Crocodile. Very good. It seems like those are working. Now, I want to go ahead do a little test on your skin. So continue to keep your eyes closed, please. I'm just going to take your hand here, and I want you to tell me if what is touching you is soft or pokey. other hand, soft or poke. Good. Chloe, I love that you and Brendan went and found emojis. Just looked there, I'm like, oh, you guys went and found the emojis. Alright, so this kind of turned into a cranial nerve exam, so I might as well finish out the rest of your senses. So I want you to go ahead and take a deep breath in of this candle and tell me what it smells like. Good. Vanilla. Such a distinct smell. And how about this one? Good. Thing we'll do. Will be to test your sense of taste. So I'm going to put these drops on your tongue and then I want you to go ahead and tell me if it is sweet, salty, spicy, or bitter. Sweet, salty, spicy, bitter. I think this will be made for me. Alright, if you will just stick out your tongue. Drink of this to clear your palate. Good. Alright, and the last one. Okay, how about this? Sour, very good. I know I gave you a double whammy with the salty and sour. Excellent. Alright. Last thing I'm going to go ahead and do is just look inside your mouth, checking the back of the throat, gum color, all that good stuff. So if you will open up and say, ah, please, ah, good, good. So I'm just looking towards the back of the throat, just looking if we're seeing any buildup, anything to indicate any illness or irritation. Also looking the color of your gums. They're a very good indicator of your health as well. Okay, alright. Little pale. Have you been properly drinking your fluids? Seems like you might be slightly dehydrated. Alright, definitely keep your hydration level up. That will also help with your restlessness while falling asleep. Alright, so just gonna go ahead and write down a couple of these recommendations that we discussed. Water intake. Also, during this time of the year, when a lot of us find ourselves potentially working indoors, your vitamin D can also become deficient. So, do you take a multivitamin? Okay, I'm going to go ahead and prescribe you a daily dosage of vitamin D as well. It's increasing water intake and also setting those nightly routines and disconnecting from any technology or extreme artificial light at least 30 minutes before bed. Really common. I live in Washington State where we're overcast, so my doctor's like, I don't even need to test you. I know you're vitamin D deficient. So I will say I'm, you know, what's the word? Disclaimer, I'm not a medical professional, so don't listen to anything I say. Consult your doctor for anything. This was just a fun role play. I really should start off like that, but okay. So, completed. No sign where you live. Same, so be safe. now, we have not had any snow in my area, which is kind of surprising usually, but we've had a really mild winter so far. Like, our temperatures have been pretty warm. Like, today, I think, was a high of like 45 or something like that. It's pretty warm for where I'm at. Okay, so we were going to do, we've had one white Christmas and it was pretty magical. Alright, so now we're going to do some X Marks the Spot and Tingle Train. I'm going to go ahead and start with Tingle Train because it's my favorite and it's mine. I'm just going to, like, my hands get sweaty in those gloves. Morrison, you can shake a stick at that. I love how you said that, Jenny. A spa night. We could do some skincare. Melt your brain. Welcome to the Tingle Train. We're gonna do that again, but my sister was showing me that you can kind of buy those, like, nail rings that slip over, and I might have to get those because I really like sharper sounding tapping like you get from acrylics, but my nails just aren't having. I could just take them off when I'm done. Alright, let's do another round. Do they hurt bad? I don't know. I gotta see how much they cost on Amazon because it might be worth trying them out, but maybe get some that are adjustable. I might have to do that. But I can see where it might be, like, pressure right on the nail. Get your thoughts unstuck. Bugs are crawling through your hair. Whispers drifting through the air. Snip, snip. Rush, rush. Let me out. And let your eyes fall shut. Soft rain to melt your brain. Welcome to the Tingle Train. All right, third time's a charm, and then we'll do some X Marks the Spot. Stipple, stipple, pluck, pluck. Let me get your thoughts unstuck. Bugs are crawling through your hair. Whispers drifting through the air. Snip, snip. Add a little have a toasted coconut and let your eyes fall shut. Soft rain to melt your brain. Move into a little bit of X marks the spot. There we go. X marks the spot. A circle and a dot. Four big holes. One tiny spot. Kittens crawling up your back, claws raking down. Kittens crawling up your back, claws raking down. Tight squeeze. Cool breathe. I feel like keeping that on there is asking for trouble, so we're gonna do it without. X marks the spot. A circle and a dot. Four big boulders and one tiny spot. Spiders crawling up your back. Spiders crawling up your back. Snakes slithering down. Tight squeeze. This is the only version I remember. I know there's more, like crisscross applesauce and dot dot line. I think I remember dot dot line. Let's see. Dot dot line line. Spiders crawling up your spine. Cracking eggs. Do the ones that don't rhyme all the way through. Something about it just scratches my brain uncomfortably when it doesn't rhyme. Like, it starts on a rhyme and then it stops. Like, just rhyme the whole way through if you're gonna rhyme. I know that's not how poetry works, but it's like it feels like the cracking egg, you know, the yolk runs down or whatever it is. I'm like, it doesn't rhyme. You couldn't come up with anything. I'll do one more of the regular X marks the spot so we can all, like, feel like we have a clean slate. X marks the spot. A circle and a dot. Four big boulders and one tiny spot. I'm glad we're all, like, the same person mentally. Kittens crawling up your back, claws squeeze. Amazing, because cats sometimes. Okay, so we're gonna do another lengthy role play. This is gonna be an all service spa salon. So we're gonna brush your hair out, we're gonna do your skincare, and I'm just going to do a really basic manicure on you. Okay, so we're gonna cover all of it, and do a hand massage, maybe a little head massage. So we'll start with the top of the head and we'll work down. So we'll start with the hair, do the face a little bit, and then move down to your hands. My cat's outside, you can hear her bell jingling. Alright, so just starting with the hair. How old is Cosmo? How old do you think he is? Did he just like wander to you one day? Like, tell me about how he adopted you. Recount me with the story. We're just gonna interesting. I thought they normally only chopped the ear when they were feral. Interesting. Oh, but poor baby. Well, I'm glad you were able to take him in and he has a good home. And now he has a brother. That's so sweet. And he's already fixed, so like, that's amazing. Circles along your scalp, starting right at the front and moving back. Well, and I don't know if it's just me, so I know surgery costs a lot of money, but I feel like growing up there were a lot of like discount, like spay and neuter programs for low income, and I feel like I don't notice that as much. Like when I was little, the local shelter, like 1 week in a month, would do discounted spay and neuter, and I don't see that anymore. I finally tracked down a feral cat program here in Washington where I live, so if the cat is trapped and is obviously feral, they will neuter and clip their ear for like $30, but that's the best I've found. And they'll do like their basic booster shots. Good. All right. facial pampering. We are going to be moving down the neck and chest as well. So, got a little kit here. See, and that's awesome. I did look in and there were a few programs, but alright. I have this nice cooling eye mask that I'm going to have you wear once we got your face mask on. We've got this Dead Sea Minerals anti-stress mask we're going to use later, which is perfect for you, because I know work has really been stressing you out. You did mention that. And I keep forgetting to bring in some new face wash, so we're just going to use shaving cream for the foamy sound. I ran out of the old stuff I was using. I really like it when it foams. Yeah, I know. And I understand that the fees, like, help keep the shelter going, but, like, not everybody can afford $100 right now. He's just like Osiris then. Thank you. It's just mascara. I tried something new with my eye makeup today. I just put like a little bit of brown shadow like in my inner corner to try and make me look more wide-eyed and awake, and I think I like it. At least it smells good. Alright, now we're just gonna go ahead and put this all over your face. Biscuits on your face. I've never had a cat make biscuits on my face, but there's that one video on TikTok of the lady who gets a video of her cat just biscuiting on the off the side. I don't know. My cats make aggressive biscuits. I don't think I could handle that. Thank you, Chloe. Is that his version of, what is that? Where they like poke your skin. What is it? Microderm. He's offering you microderm services. Hopefully he washed those little claws of his. Alright. Now let's go ahead and get that wash off. So we're just gonna... I know I spent good part of my time on TikTok scrolling through like those facial ASMR videos, and I am by no means a dermatologist or a massage therapist or anything, but I think we're gonna do a mock video like that, because I think I can at least follow. None of it will have the expertise, but I can make it look relaxing. That's not the next step. I'm talking and getting out of order. Okay. Now that we've cleansed your face, we're going to go ahead and tone it. I got a little bit of Thayer's facial toner with witch hazel. I know, they're so good, Avery. And I'm like I said, it won't look, I mean, it won't be factual, but it'll, I can make it look relaxing. I feel like it's just about the personal attention anyway. Alright, we're just going to pat this over your face. Let that sit on the skin. You're gonna feel a little bit of tightness. That just means that it's working. I'm gonna go ahead and get some of the facial serums out that we're going to use. But next up, we're gonna go ahead and put on this sea mask. We're just gonna let sit on your face. And while that's happening, I'm gonna go ahead and I didn't think this through, so we're going to apply this with this. We're just going to smear this all over the face. And this is going to clear pores, smooth skin, unwind from the grind by treating skin to a much needed respite. Freeman should cast me in a commercial. I could do it. Okay, just spreading this out, making sure to give some space, thank you, Emery, around the eyes. Don't want to cause any irritation. Okay. This grueling mask on your face. Just go ahead and just imagine that's gonna sit on your face the whole time, okay? Alright, and while that's sitting on your face, we're gonna go ahead and do just a real basic manicure. I'm just gonna shape your nails a little bit. We'll add some clear polish, and then I'll give you a hand massage, okay? Excellent. I have my board here. Let me see your hand. Good. We're just gonna just shaping the nail. Thank you, Rin. Glad you enjoyed. Look at that and tell me if you like the shape. A little bit more almond. Okay, easy enough to do. And the best part is the hand massage. So I have this nice rosemary mint soothing balm. Alright, if you want to just hold out your hand. Hopefully this will help a little bit. What's up? sometimes helps me also to kind of trick myself into getting tired is to take slower, deeper breaths. So maybe while watching this, if you just do some slower, deeper breathing, maybe it'll start to trick your body into a relaxed state. But I'm sorry. I hope it works for you, Emery. They tend to work all right for me. Not always, but a good amount of the time. Or putting on something like, sometimes like Bob Ross or David Attenborough, one of those like really like even melodious voices tend to put me to sleep. Who doesn't want to fall asleep to Happy Little Trees? Yeah, documentaries. And I love David Attenborough's voice, so most of the ones I watch are his. I live in the U.S. on the West Coast, so it is only 7 p.m. my time. Oh, that's pretty. So you're in a totally new space tonight? Yeah, that's always hard, especially that first night. I mean, I feel that way, but East Coasters might disagree. Alright, now let's go ahead and massage this arm. How's that face mask doing? To be fair, I haven't been to the East Coast, so I have no comparison. None. Just countrywide rivalry. Which coast is better, West Coast or East Coast? Yeah, and when you're going through something like that, Sophia, it might take a little bit because you're in a foreign place, which, you know, being in a different space than what you're used to immediately puts people on edge. And also, if you're still in, like, high anxiety or stress response state, but I hope you're safe where you are, and I hope that for a little bit, hanging out here can give you a little sense of peace, maybe, but I'm glad you were able to get out of your situation. See, now I'm gonna have to travel over to Emory and judge it for myself. He's ghosted. Yeah, and it'll take a while for you to feel safe, probably. Off these little soothing eye pads. Now we're going to go ahead and wipe off. I do love the way it smells up here. It smells like rain and green things. You do have good timing, Taryn. Alright. Excuse me, I have to itch my nose. There we go. I really try not to pick my nose on alive, but sometimes I'm like, I just gotta get in there and just dig for a little bit. Alright, now I go ahead and add some. That's one thing about having a septum, is every once in a while it'll like kink one of my nose hairs in a weird direction. And it tickles so much. Is that the phone ringing downstairs? Yeah, this is the phone. Because we still have a house phone. And I don't know why, because we never use it. The only people who call are telemarketers. Gotta find this towel. I have too much product on my hands now. There was our serum. And now we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit of facial oil and then moisturizer. We'll give you a bit of a face massage. Here is some of that facial oil. A lot of us are worried about U.S. crime too, believe me. Thank you, Star. You know, Sophia, I honestly don't know. That is probably a question best left to like a medical professional, but I think any type of calming exercises might help you. So, focusing on your surroundings, you know, kind of tuning into the here and now, into your senses, focusing on your breath and on your body. Trying to create an environment where you might feel a little bit more safe and secure. Sometimes it's double checking that doors and windows are locked if your physical safety is concerned. Maybe it's putting on a little bit of background noise or maybe a little night light. extra blankets so you can kind of feel like you're able to hide under the covers a bit. Kind of those things that might make you feel safe. Maybe holding a stuffy or a squishmallow or any type of other comfort item. Massaging that oil into the skin. And then you feel a lot more relaxed. I can tell that you are glowing. Your skin looks wonderful. And then I'll go ahead and put this away before I knock anything else over. When I was digging around for props for tonight, different activities, look what I found. The little squirrel hands. It's been a while since I stroked your face with the little squirrel hands. I'm feeling like that level of weird tonight, so might do a little bit of a head and face massage. A little bit scratchy, so they create a nice sensation on the face. Just gonna scratch, scratch, scratch. That is a good question. Do they make tapping sounds? I've never tried. Kind of. Probably better. The problem is I can't get like the individual nails. Just what I like. It has like the little like toe beans that squirrels have. Okay. these were actually like a gag gift for, so it was like a white elephant, one of those white elephant, but like with just gag gifts that we did at work 1 year. And my boss got this little like puppet squirrel, and I asked him if I could have the hands for his money. He gave the squirrel the head, but I got the hands. I have not been snowboarding before, good God. I actually really haven't done any snow activities. I'm actually doing my first like cross-country skiing excursion next month. We're going out to stay at a cabin, some friends and I, so we'll see. Never done it. Thank you. Okay, so now you're Hello Kitty. I'll have to remember that. Long time no see. Hello Kitty. Meek. Meek. Hello Kitty. If I say it enough, I'll remember. Yeah, so any tips, I would appreciate. I know you're supposed to like be able to slide, but I literally know nothing about skiing. I'm just renting some for the day and going. The people I'm going with have been there before, so I'm hoping it won't be too bad. Some other props. Look, we haven't had our shark friend out. We had him named, and I don't remember what his name was. Anyone remember what we named him? Okay, dress warm and comfy. I will have to grab Frankie. He's right there on the shelf. So I'll get Frankie next. I feel like, what did we call him? You had a name, friend. It's been so long that I recall. Bruce would have made sense. I feel like we played around with Bruce, but I felt like it was like Captain something with an S. But I don't remember what it was. Look at this guy do the worm. He does it much better than I do. Steve. Steve would have been a good one. I felt like it was something kind of obnoxious, like Sir Ludwig. I don't know. What's doesn't matter. He's the tingle shark now. I don't know. I know we do. I do remember Frankie the Frog, because I was thinking Frank Sinatra. So Frankie, I remember. I do kind of like Bruce, though. Sinister Sid. Because Bruce, I could remember because it's an actual shark. Whoosh. Now he's going to do a little bit of belly dancing. These hips don't lie. Bruce Esquire. We could do Captain Bruce Finnington. Bruce Finnington. Something like that when we went back. session where I had to be like, it was like a goat D&D session. We were goats and we had to do something, but I was a fancy goat, and I think I came up with like Sir Ramwell Buntington or something like that. It's like, that sounds like a proper sophisticated goat name. He does need a monocle. I am sad to say I do not possess any monocles at this time. And here is our Frankie Sinatra. Complicated question, but I think it would involve like a large socio-political overhaul. At this point, nothing. I mean, I think it's one of those things that's gonna crash and burn and then just have to be rebuilt. Like, what was everyone saying? That every 200 years an empire crumbles? Little froggy, look at him. Oh, cheese steak. That sounds amazing. I haven't eaten dinner yet. I'm gonna eat after the live. Don't know if you've been able to hear my tummy occasionally rumbling, but it has been doing so. All right. So I think I've gone through pretty much all of the triggers that I had pre-prepared. So we shall open up the floor. Anyone wants a certain type of trigger, we can give it a go if I've got the correct props and gumption. I have to wash my hands after this. I still have oil all over them. Definitely do another eye exam. Yes, we did that earlier, but if you all really like it, I'm happy to do another medical exam. I still have all the props out for it. I think if it were more affordable to do so, a lot of people would have already done so, if I'm being perfectly honest. Very expensive to move, so I don't think it can happen as much as people want. Welcome back. All right, we'll go ahead and do another medical role play. So just sit down. We're gonna take some basic measurements. I'm gonna take your temperature. We're gonna take a listen to your heart and lungs. And then we'll go ahead and check kind of your basic physiology and also do a test on your five senses. Okay. Yeah, I think if it were more affordable to do so, I would definitely long term think about leaving. I have no idea where to. I hadn't thought that far, but. Alright, so. Start by listening to your lung and heart. So just just go ahead and breathe normally for me. Good. Okay. Excellent. Now go ahead and take a deep breath in. I think Ireland is pretty close to the climate we have here in Washington. I feel like I'd like to stay in like a kind of wet, overcast climate. So probably anywhere up in that area. Alright, another deep breath in. So I'm hearing just the slightest buildup in your lungs. Are you by any chance just getting over a cold? Okay, yeah, just hearing a little bit of that. Are you experiencing any other symptoms? I am going to go ahead and take a temperature right now. Alright, temperature is good. Just a little bit of I don't think the overcast is depressing, but everyone's very different. So for me, I live in Western Washington, where you get a lot of rain, and it's very green, and I love that. It's like moody forest woods. So I enjoy that. That's enough of a caveat for me, but not everybody's the same, and I've only lived here since 2017, so we'll see. I hear it gets harder the longer it is, but I got my lifetime supply of sun when I lived in California, so I don't miss it. Yeah, I'm glad it's helping me. Took your temperature. Okay, so just a little bit of buildup in the lungs, a little bit of runny nose, so I will ask you to continue drinking plenty of water and maybe some decongestants like teas, just to help. Alright, so let's go ahead and take a look at your eyes next. So I want you to start just by looking right at my nose, please. Good. Just starting with your pupil reaction. Noticing a little bit of irritation. Have you been rubbing your eyes a lot? See, that was my stomach. We cannot. Alright, good. And I want you to go ahead and follow the light for me. Follow the light just with your eyes. Go ahead and keep your head still. Concentrated too. I hope you washed your eye out really well. Okay, good. Now, I want you to go ahead and focus right on the tip of my nose and tell me when my fingers leave your peripheral vision, okay? Think those little innocuous packages are fine, but anytime you have concentrated product like that. Alright, focusing on the tip of my nose and tell me how many fingers you see. Up this medical role play, do car ride, and then we'll do some positive affirmations. Okay, test in the eyes. Let's go ahead and test your ears. So just close your eyes, close your eyes, and then tell me what side of your head you hear the snapping on. Whisper a number into each ear. If you can go ahead and repeat that number back to me, okay? 45 45. Good. 72 72. That's all right. I'm glad you took the time to take care of yourself. Ears are working. So now we're going to check your sense of smell. So I want you to go ahead and take a deep breath in of this candle. Just inhale it. All right. And tell me what it smells like to the best of your ability. Very good. Very good. All right. And this one, take a deep breath in. That's so specific, Nisha. I love it. Deep breath in. I feel like if someone actually gave me like a scent test and gave me something like cashmere, I'd feel really cheated. Good job. Alright. And then last, we're gonna go ahead and Target has really good candles. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put some drops of this on your tongue. And I want you to tell me if it is sweet, salty, bitter, or spicy. Okay, can I get up on my soapbox for a second? So I was sniffing candles at Bath & Body Works. This was a hot minute ago. This was probably like pretty close to a year. But I was sniffing their candles, and I don't think Bath & Body Works candles smell very good. I like a lot of their lotions, but for like a $22 candle, I didn't like them. I didn't like any of them. They're just a little too, like, complicated smelling. Alright, go ahead and give this a try. Alright, how about that? And see, I don't know if that's when I got to smell. It was a lot of, like, winter themed at the time, and I just didn't like any of them. Yes, that one is spicy, very good. Sorry about that. Alright, last thing. Just go ahead and take a look inside your mouth. You'll open up and say, ah, for me. Just looking towards the back of the throat and just examining your gum condition, looking at the coloration and overall health. Excellent. This concludes your medical exam. Yes, Woodwick is some of my favorite. So, This one is actually my newest candle. It's not wood wick, but it's another crackling one. It's Threshold, and it's sandalwood and smoke. And I love it. It smells like, it's a masculine scent, but I think like incense almost. I love it so much. You can hear him still sniffling, but it's such a good smell. Yeah, it was all about the crackles. Christmas tree hands up. See that? Like a musky smell or like straight up edible food smell. I love those too. I'm like, I either want to like eat it or have like a really nice dense smell to it. What were you doing next? Car ride and then affirmations. I am paying attention, I swear. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and turn off the ring light. So lights off in 3, 2, 1. All right, so we are doing a car ride. We're just gonna get just a hair closer. Come in. So I want you to go ahead and close your eyes. White musk, good stuff. And I want you to imagine that you're riding in the passenger seat of a vehicle. Someone you love and trust very much is driving. The heater's turned up, so it's very comfortable. And the gentle rumble of the vehicle you feel safe, content, and relaxed. You are driving back from selecting your Christmas tree. For the first time, you went to a eucalypt grove, and so you wandered through the tree. You chose a petite, noble fir with a beautiful evergreen smell and nice firm branches to hold up all of your flashy weighted ornaments. You and your friend spent a hilarious amount of time sawing through the tree, and you made sure to dramatically yell timber as it fell, and it was quite a workout sawing through the tree. So now you're in just a little bit of a nap, watching the Christmas tree is secured to the top of your vehicle, and you can hear it, its stray branches fluttering in the wind, and you're dreaming of all the decorations you're gonna put on it once you get home. And just as you think that, car comes to a gentle stop, and your friend nudges you awake. It's time to enjoy some hot cocoa and then decorate the tree. And the lights are going to come on in 3, 2, 1. was relaxing, Scarlett. Yeah. I'm just gonna stretch it out really quick. Let's see, we've been live for almost 2 hours now. Take a minute to do a stretch. Yawn. Good for stretching out the back, and it's comforting. Stretching it out. Okay. Ugh. Yeah, I started a little early. I started at, 6 p.m. my time. Because I was supposed to go live on Friday, and I meant to go live on Saturday, and that didn't happen. So I'm really sorry, but I figured we'd do an extra long live to make up for it. Alright. Positive affirmation. So we're going to do some plucking and planting for that. The all-nighter live, you missed it. We had that a while ago, the 20K live. That was the camping live. We did it. Don't cry. I did record a good portion of it. Well, I recorded after I had fallen asleep in the rain, and it's on YouTube if you want to watch it. We'll have to do another one soon. I just gotta plan it out because I was exhausted the next day. So we'll have to plan another one. I think y'all had a lot of fun with that. Alright, so I'm just getting out my tools here. Also going to plant. So we're going to pluck a lot of those negative thoughts, and we're going to plant positive ones. So I'm not really great at these, so just bear with me. Alright, so we're going to start by plucking a little bit of this anxiety. See, you're worrying a lot about the future and constantly going over different possible scenarios. And while I understand that you want to be prepared for every possible eventuality, just come up with more and more extreme possibilities. And what I want to plant instead is the confidence and understanding that no matter what happens, that you have the perseverance and the good judgment to see it through to the best of your. Instead of constantly worrying about what may or may not happen, recognize that you are capable of doing your absolute best in any given situation. And now we're going to go ahead and pluck away this heaviness, this sadness and depression. I've also spent a lot of time beating yourself up for things that have already happened. So I started at, hi Kylie, I started at 6 p.m. my time, and we're going to go to at least 8:30. So we've got about another 45 minutes. So both, I started a little early and I'm going a little later. And what I want to plant instead is a little bit of forgiveness in yourself. So recognizing that you aren't able to change events that have already happened. Best you could at the time. And since then, you've also grown and learned. So anything that has already passed, stressful feelings. Let's see. We've done quite a bit tonight. We've done a couple role plays. Only a little bit of hairbrushing, so we'll go ahead and fit some of that in next for you. And hair styling. Even things you experienced were frightening, were painful, embarrassing. Those things happened to a different person. A person you have since grown from. They don't have to constantly weigh on the greater purpose. But ultimately, each of us gets to decide what our purpose is. But I would say focusing on those things that fulfill you, and they don't have to be these great world can be small things, like doing something nice for the ones you love, creating something and giving yourself a sense of satisfaction, reading and creating. Now we will leave these seeds to sprout and grow. gonna water them with lots of self-love. Plenty of self-care. Kind of me making me think of my sister and I just watched Evan Almighty the other night, and he has these words, the character Evan Baxter, that he repeats to himself in the mirror. What is it? I'm handsome, I'm successful. Anyway, they're words of affirmation you can repeat to yourself. Because, as my therapist told me, your brain doesn't like to be wrong. It's gonna find ways to prove itself right. So, if you repeat and think as much as you possibly can, positive or affirming thoughts, your brain's gonna try and find reasons to make those things true. So tell yourself that you're valid. Tell yourself that you are successful. Tell yourself that you are powerful. And your brain will convince you it is so. You become them more each and every day. I don't know my cock, Natalie. Who is my cock? Might leave the foamy on. No, we're gonna do hair. We have to put the other one on. We're gonna do hair brushing. Now we have your fluffy head of hair here. I'm still really zoomed in. Let me zoom out just a bit. I don't feel like I'm so like up in your business. Go ahead and drive, Mark. Alright, now let's go ahead. I forgot to mention, great question for you all. So I have an appointment on Friday. I think I should be able to go live at our normal time, but I'll keep you posted. I've got a tattoo session scheduled a couple hours away. So if not, do you guys want to try and do, I don't know, like a Christmas Day live? I feel like everyone would be busy. But what would be a good alternate day? I think I'm busy Saturday. Christmas Day. I don't have plans for Christmas Day, so I don't mind doing a Christmas Day live. Alright, if for whatever reason this Friday's live has to be moved, we'll go ahead and move it to Christmas Day, which is... Wait, is it Monday or Sunday? Because I'm already going live on Monday, I think. Okay, I gotta... What day of the week are we in? 18th. 19th is a Tuesday. 20th is a Wednesday. 21st is a Thursday. 22nd. So 23rd, I have plans, but not Sunday. So I could also do it Sunday, because I think I should already be going live on Monday. It is Monday. Thank you, Morgan. Somebody with a calendar in front of them. Thank you all. Yes, so if we have to move, I'm totally fine doing Christmas Eve, because I normally go live on Mondays anyway, so I am happy to do one on Christmas. Like I said, I don't have plans. And I got it off for the first time in forever. I'm sorry for all of you who are forced or are asked to work Christmas, but I did get this one off. But to all my retail and restaurant peeps who are working, kudos to you. I will be staying out of your establishment so you are not extra busy. I will be home. Well, that should be fun because this will be your first Christmas with the in-laws, right? You get along with them okay so far? Alright, now let's go ahead and do a little bit of styling now. Gotta get my trusty yes and no. I feel like that's a universal thing about in-laws. I guess it's good that there's a yes in there. So, I'm thinking, what about two fishtail braids? I feel like it's been a while since I braided your hair in fishtails. So let me just split it down. So for the fishtail braid, we're going to separate it into two strands, and we're going to take a little section from like the back side of one strand and add it to the other, and we just kind of do that all the way down, and it creates this nice fold effect. And the smaller you make the sections, like the more intricate the braid looks. So we're just going to keep adding across all the Okay, I will drink water. Look, I have some in my spray bottle. I forgot my glass again. Good reminder for everyone to stay hydrated and take a water break. I finally downloaded a water, like, tracker because I've not been consuming enough water. It is a little bit. Don't judge, it's the only water available. You know what? It's really helped because I was getting these like constant low-grade headaches, and I'm pretty sure it's because I was severely dehydrated. So the problem is all I want to drink is coffee instead. Alright, we're gonna tie that braid off. Love me some espresso, like a latte. Okay, let me just unclip that. The problem is, since I was drinking all coffee and not enough water. So, like today, I was a little mad today. I got like a 24-ounce coffee, and I don't think I finished it until like 4 p.m. Not my best moment, but I was just like, I woke up with like raccoon zombie eyes because I didn't sleep very well last night. So I was like, caffeine is the only way we will make it through this Monday. Luckily, it was very chill at work today. But it took 24 ounces of caffeine to get there. Just continuing that fishtail braid all the way down. Oh, I'm sorry if you're all yawning with me. Okay, we're gonna braid, tie that off. Nice. Good. I'm glad people are tipping. Do tips go up or down around the holidays, or do they stay the same? I find if I can financially, I try and be a little bit more generous during the holidays. But again, it just kind of depends on your situation. Okay, good. I feel like that's like a general thing that people do. Alright. Here. Chicken Run has a sequel. I'm not even. Did I even watch the first one? What I did see is it looks like they're trying to redo Land Before Time, and it looks weird. It doesn't look right. Sarah isn't even a Triceratops anymore. She's a different frilled dinosaur, and I'm not okay with it. I'm like, that's one I don't think that they can, like, change up that much. Not even that late. All that coffee's wearing off, that's what's happening. Just gonna peer at you oddly through my magnifying glass. We're gonna play a game of trying to center. Trying to center the ring light reflections. You can see my elbow. Hi, there I am. Peering creepily at you. Hello. Hello. I think they're going to. I think it's just bound to happen. They're going to review it. Renew it. But I just, what I saw, I was not very impressed with. We did. We brushed it out and we did two fishtail braids on each side. Can add a couple butterflies in the braid. And here we have Captain Bruce Finnington. That's what we just named him earlier today. Okay. Let's add some butterflies. It's been a while since we broke out the hair accessories anyway. And look at this beautiful collection of butterflies. Butterflies. So we're just gonna scatter them randomly up and down your braid. So I'm starting with this pretty pink one. Very nice. And what I'm gonna do is I'm definitely gonna put like matching pairs on each side, but I'm gonna separate them. Can do ear cleaning. I even have my toilet paper roll handy. Alright, so we did a pink one. Ooh, let's do this green one. I love this one. Very nice. These actually go really well in your fishtail. But like split, so two down each side. Think like volleyball or basketball tournament, that kind of. So we're kind of adding them to both sides. And let's do this. I feel like I need to try this hairstyle on Jess. Like French braid her hair and then scatter a bunch of butterflies in. Where's my other pink one? Am I missing one? I'm missing the other powder pink one. Well, this is a sad day. Okay, we're gonna do this yellow one. And I'm missing that one too. I do with it. It's probably buried in one of my drawers. Not like I don't have plenty, but I'm like, it's not a complete set now. Alright, so we got that. So now let's do a little bit of ear cleaning. I need before you have to visit your in-laws. Good luck. Alright, so seeing a little bit of wax buildup. There is a small foreign object I'm noticing. I'm going to try and grab that first. Let's see, I'm not entirely sure what that is. Let me just reach back. Good news is, it doesn't look like it was a living organism at any point. There goes my stomach. So it looks like the little like bar, the cap on an earring, that's what I'm trying to say, the little bell part of it. Looks like you might have got that step back there. So anyway, we got that taken care of. Go ahead and start to get rid of some of this wax. Yeah, looks like it just got stuck. Okay, now we're just gonna do a little bit of brushing. Just kind of soothing the ear canal. A little bit of light brushing, just cleaning up any last minute debris. Okay. I'm gonna take one more look with light, just to verify we've got everything nice and cleaned up. Good. Alright, everything looks wonderful. And just in time, because my shoulders were about to give out. I have to like prop my shoulders up when I do that. The sacrifices I make. else should we do? Pew, 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 pew. Was there something else on the list that I already forgot? Ooh, water sounds. We haven't done any of that tonight, Malia. So, I have some options. Where's my jar full of questionable water? I think I'm growing stuff in this. Yes, yes I am. It's like slowly turning into like a pond. I have not opened this. It's like starting to be seaweedy. Do a little bit of water sounds, and I think we might go ahead and do some energy rain. I've done a couple light triggers tonight. I think I want to mix it up. The weather has been very mild, so we haven't gotten a ton of rain. Like, we had a couple days where it rained a lot, but not a lot of rain. It's been relatively warm. It's been like 45, which is pretty warm for this time of year. I'm glad I got your name right. It's always a bit of a gamble. Alright, we're gonna put... Gotta turn that off, sorry. So we like half made this the other day. It's got little gemstones, but I'm gonna go ahead and use it. Some rain sounds. Thank you for the roses. We might have time to do a face massage too. So add energy rain, face massage. I'm gonna finish off with water sounds right here. Sounds pretty good. Pretty sure selenite should not get wet. That's pretty good. Thank you. And then we're gonna do energy rain and face massage. Okay, so the tapping is not entirely to be on point. We'll make it work. So this is ASMR Noah's Trigger Energy Rain. It's gonna be pluck, 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 snip, snip, snip. And I don't have acrylics on, so. Sound the same without acrylics. Okay, that's how I'm gonna have to do the rain. So pluck, 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 snip, snip, snip. No nails, no problem. We innovate, we overcome. Look, really love to have them, but I think one of the press-on products I got, I might be allergic to, because I've got quite a bit of redness and irritation cropping up. So we're going to take a break from any fancy nail products for a little bit until I don't look like I just burnt the crap out of my hands. I did know they don't hurt, which is good, but I'm definitely seeing some concerning skin reactions, so. Alright, and face massage. Alright, and let's just get right. I love him so much. He's so cute. I actually, on Friday, am getting an addition to this. So, you'll probably get to see that in a few weeks, but we're getting more added. Did it finally go away for you, Cassie? Or, like, what ended up happening? I kind of feel like that's what might have did me in. Thank you, Genesis, for the army. Did you by any chance happen to use UV activated glue? You know, we can probably close out with my nibbling tonight. I'd be fine with that. That's what I did. I bought some UV activated glue, because I had a different glue that wasn't UV activated that I didn't have a reaction to, but I just got some UV stuff, and I think that's a no-go for me. We are going to be live for about another 10 minutes, so we'll go ahead and do like the last couple minutes of my nibbling before we close out. We have been live about 2.5 hours now, and my tummy cannot take any more rumbling. I need to go get dinner. Like rain sounds, Sophia. You prefer rain sounds. Question, Tully. I haven't prepared anything, so it might be like a ramen type of night, like some top ramen and just calling it, but we'll see. It's probably, I'm gonna get downstairs and figure it out. Because that's my go-to when I haven't planned anything, it's just some top ramen. Did everyone have for dinner? Let me hear so I can dream and figure out what I'm gonna do. What was everyone's dinner for the evening? Oh, Popeye's chicken, quesadillas. the only one who sometimes just munches on chips for dinner. Every once in a while, that's my dinner too. Oh, ravioli. Oh, that sounds so good. Turkey burger. I remember the cheese stick. I definitely want something like warm. Definitely like a hot food. That's what I'm feeling. Alright, let me see if I can find my Apple headphones. Okay, we'll finish up with some mic nibbling for y'all. So, you can still see the last time I did this, I was wearing like a dark lipstick. So this will be kind of intense mouth sounds. I try not to overdo it because I don't like it when they're too intense, but it will be right on the mic here. Hopefully, as long as I give me a thumbs up if it works, because I don't get any live listening on the Apple headphones, so hopefully they're working. Just gonna unplug this so now we're gonna have a little bit of lo-fi for a minute while I get these bad boys plugged in. This mic never dies on me, because do they even make corded headphones for Apple anymore? Is it all like AirPods? They probably do. YouTube. If you don't already, we do post tons of content. There's like 450 videos or something like that over there. And as always, we are going to go ahead and close out the live with a little bit of a countdown. My sister will be going live tomorrow on this channel at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. If you want to join her for some more